please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Good evening. You're watching CNBC TV 18 with me, Parikshit Luthra. The big political story we've all been following all these weeks. Pranab Mukherjee, the former president of India at the RSS headquarters in Nagpur, he will be addressing 700 RSS workers. What is he going to be speaking on? That is a complete mystery. He was at the Hedgewar Memorial a short while back. Remember, Hedgewar is somebody who himself actively participated in the Indian National Congress in the 1920s and was even sentenced to imprisonment for a year for his role in the Khilafat movement. A lot of reactions have been coming in. The Congress Party extremely angry. Anand Sharma of the Congress Party, a former minister, has said that his reaction and Pranab Da's move has really anguished thousands of Congress workers across the country. Will the Congress now distance itself from Pranab Mukherjee in the days to come? This is something we'll have to really wait and watch. But we're going to be getting you pictures, and we are getting you pictures right now of Mohan Bhagwat and Pranab Mukherjee there sitting together. The Congress has been hoping that Pranab Mukherjee will lash out at the RSS. There has also been commentary that RSS is seeking legitimacy at a time when BJP's chips are down. This has snowballed into a big political controversy. And the Congress line is very clear that they are disappointed with Pranab Mukherjee. Ahmed Patel, who's the closest aide of Sonia Gandhi, tweeted earlier today where he said, "I did not expect this from Pranab Da." And that's not all. Sharmishtha Mukherjee, who has been silent over the last few days, has also lashed out at her father, saying that citizen Pranab Mukherjee is just giving a big handle to the RSS and the BJP to spread false rumours. Because there was a report, There were reports on social media which said that Sharmishtha Mukherjee could be joining the BJP. Now, that was something that was rebutted by Sharmishtha Mukherjee and the Congress Party. And not just Ahmed Patel and Anand Sharma. You've been hearing the likes of Sushil Kumar Shinde. You've heard from Veerbhadra Singh as well. Interestingly, Veerbhadra Singh and Sushil Kumar Shinde are members of the old guard who are actually supporting the move, and they don't think there is anything wrong in that. But many of the younger leaders have been disappointed. Adhir Ranjan Chaudhary has been demanding that Pranab Mukherjee must make it clear whether he has changed his stand on the RSS. For more on this, let's go across to CNN News 18.
Sorry, you know nothing about him.
Sharma, no, Mr. Digam, I'm telling you.
You know nothing about him.
He is closely watched and cover the Congress Party. He is not a stenographer.
See, he was a congressman.
Yeah.
He was a congressman.
But
that was the Congress line at that point of time. And he was following that line, whether staunchly or not staunchly. And today, he is not following the Congress line. He's taken an independent line. Hmm. That time he was a congressman. He was following a particular Congress ideology at that point of time. Hmm. So he had that notion. But today, he's rejected that notion.
Okay. No, okay, Mr. We've got R.P. Singh of the BJP.
The question
spokesperson
is not about line. The question is how facts stand.
But we've got Mr. R.P. Singh also, the BJP,
Mahatma
joining
Gandhi
us.
Mahatma Gandhi called the RSS a communal
critical of the Congress Mr. Party Gandhi. For attacking Pranab Mukherjee before he is speaking. The BJP tweets are also already praising Pranab Mukherjee before he is speaking. Shouldn't you, like the Congress Party, also wait and watch?
Well, we believe in dialogue. And once we believe in dialogue, I mean, we will wait what he has to say. And then He can criticize. He can criticize from that dais, and then we'll accept that. I mean, the ideology will accept that. But I'm shocked. My friend Adil Bhopale was talking about the Congress ideology. Do Congress have an ideology? They have an ideology which they picked up from left. I mean, it's a rented ideology from the left. They don't have an ideology of their own. So what ideology is speaking about? Corruption as ideology, coming to power as ideology. This only ideology which is left within Congress today. There's no one, nothing more than that.
You see this BJP's obsession with the left is as strong as the RSS's obsession with the Congress and Congress's with the RSS. They're scared of the left. You see, the left in India is the biggest ideological bulwark against the RSS. In Parliament, I have never seen a BJP RSS member winning an argument against a left member. I've never seen it.
But we know the new argument. I've not seen it once. Pranab Mukherjee has often been criticized for being so pro-left.
Yeah. His role models were all from the left.
All the left.
Somebody saying that left has lost relevance. May I tell you one thing? The economic differences between the RSS frontal organizations on economic issues with the government are always lean towards the left. Please, we have studied this closely. They try to occupy the opposition space by attacking the government of the day, which is the BJP government on economic policies. This is the strategy. But then that attack is always has an orientation which is leaning towards the left, because we are a welfare state. The generation of wealth and distribution of wealth has not been even-handed yet in this country. So we need to think of those lines. And there is nothing wrong if you're thinking like that. So I think that we should not, sitting here, because we are pro-dialogue, be denouncing any ideology which is there in this country. You see, this country is great because you name a fruit, you have it. You name a season, you have it. You name an ideology, you have it. And that is why we have proved Churchill wrong.
But is it...
We have checks and balances in the system.
But is it that Mr. Mukherjee has actually figured out that the answer to right is not being left but being center? And Congress has left the center space vacuum.
Now, you see, the point is, please understand, Congress is still a centrist party with, who's a democratic ally of the left. Please understand. I am a democratic ally of the left. I am a centrist. I am a democratic liberal. But an ally of the left in certain issues. These things are there. From issue to issue, it changes. If you are a thinking human being.
I'll respond. Mm-hmm. Congress was...
I supported Vajpayee's pro-Pakistan line.
Congress always positioned itself as left of the center. It never said it's a centrist party. And in fact, it moved more towards the left.
Yes, increasingly.
And increasingly moved towards the left. And the
this is your interpretation.
Adil, there was a certain section within the opposition parties who were perhaps looking at Pranab Mukherjee being the binding or the uniting factor. Many of you are comparing Pranab at RSS with Advani at the Jinnah. You think after today, Pranab Mukherjee will become untouchable for the Congress party? It would be very unfortunate, but do you think there's a possibility?
Pallaviji, you need
They've
to understand.
Done that.
One minute, Mr. Singh.
Pranab Mukherjee is concerned. Can I respond, please? I respond? As far as former President Mukherjee is concerned, I think we should.
All right, all eyes on Nagpur at this point. What is Pranab Mukherjee going to say? Will it have an impact on 2019? Keep watching CNBC TV 18. We'll be back after a short break.